I will be doing a read aloud of the passage Trail of Tears. At the beginning of the 1830s, about 125,000 Native Americans lived in the southeastern part of the United States. 10 years later, very few remained. The government wanted to help plantation owners grow cotton on the land where the Indians lived. And remember, we're calling Indians here in this passage the same as Native Americans. They forced the Indians to leave their homes and travel to a new territory given to them across the Mississippi River. This journey has been called the Trail of Tears. Americans were afraid of Indians and thought they shouldn't have a right to the land which white settlers wanted. They thought the Indians were inferior to them, which means below them. In the early days of America, some people thought that the best way to prevent or stop problems with the Indians was to make them like Americans. They should be taught English, become Christians, and learn about private ownership of lands. This was George Washington's belief. The blank, this Cocotua, Chickawa, Cherokee, Seminole, and Creek tribes in the southeast did try to do this. They were called the five civilized tribes. So let me just stop for a second and explain this. So the people from Europe that came over here did not think the Native Americans should have any land. And they think they were only going to even consider it to these five tribes, this one, two, three, four, five, if they knew English, became a Christian, and were okay with being having private ownership of the lands, which for Native Americans, most of them believed that the land belonged to everyone, to God, and to their gods. So this was really a bad problem. Okay, so anyway. However, as the settlers wanted more land to grow cotton, they didn't care if the Indians were civilized. All they wanted was they wanted all the land. They said that the Indians stole livestock and burned houses. The settlers wanted the Indians gone. Some state governments were in favor of taking the lands belonging to the Indians. The Supreme Court was against this practice and said that the Indians had sovereign rights over their land. However, the Indians continued to be mistreated. So this paragraph, okay, I want to make sure, because I know my dog was walking back and forth in the background and her nails were clicking. So what this is basically saying is that these people in the United States, the Americans, even though these Native Americans were trying, the Americans became greedy and they wanted all the land. And then they started saying that Native Americans stole things from them and burned their houses. And eventually they just wanted them to be gone. They wanted the Native Americans all out of the place. So some states said that the colonists, which became Americans, said, oh, yeah, sure, you have the right to just take that land from them. However, the Supreme Court said that that was not okay and that the Native Americans needed to be able to have their land because it was theirs to begin with. But even though the Supreme Court made this ruling, there was still people mistreating the Native Americans. Here's where it gets bad. All right. So President Andrew Jackson was in favor of removing the Indians to allow the white settlers to have the land. Guys, he is telling the white people, hey, I don't care if these Native Americans were here before us. You guys should have the land. Sickening. He had previously been involved in many military campaigns against the Indians in the Southeast, which resulted in taking away land from the Indians and giving it to white settlers. He passed the Indian Removal Act, which replaced land taken from the Indians in the southeast with land west of the Mississippi, which is now Oklahoma. Let me break it down. Let's say you're in Mrs. Brooks' class and you have your desk. And all of a sudden, she says, you can't have that desk because it's only for a white person. And then, no matter what's in that land, what's inside your desk, it's not yours anymore. Well, then the president, or we'll just say the principal, comes in and says, you know what? This person doesn't even have to have a desk. We can put their desk down in the cafeteria. And that's kind of what they did. They said, if you want this, then here you can have it, but you have to have it in this location. It's really, really sad. So, by law, the Indians were to be treated fairly with this process, but that didn't happen, guys. But Jackson wanted them removed by force. This tribe were the first tribe to be forcibly driven out. They were made to walk hundreds of miles without any help from the government, such as food, clothing, and other supplies. Many died along the way. So, guys, I'm serious when I tell you this. All of a sudden, they just had to go leave their house and walk hundreds of miles with no food, no water, nothing to help them survive, and just try to go make a new house somewhere else. One leader called it the Trail of Tears and Death. The removal kept going. The Creeks, that's another tribe, were driven out of their lands in 1836. 3,500 of the 15,000 who made the march died. That's really sad. In 1835, amidst opposition, a few representatives from the Cherokee made a treaty with the government that they would leave land east of the Mississippi in exchange for $5 million and relocation help. Many of the Cherokees felt betrayed. They all didn't want to leave. By 1838, only about 2,000 Cherokees had left. President Martin Van Buren sent the army under General Winfield Scott to Georgia to remove them by force. They put the Indians in stockades and looted their homes. So they basically put them in jails and then went into their houses and took everything that they could. They forced them to walk 1,200 miles to the Indian Territory. You guys, that is a lot of miles. Most of us only walk like 2 miles a day. Okay, more than 5,000 died on the way from disease and starvation.